Sing praise to his name, give to him glory. us praise through the prayers of the Theotokos. O Savior, save us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen. Through the prayers of the Theotokos, O Savior, save us. Be gracious to us, O God, and bless us. Let your face shine upon us and have mercy on us. O Son of God, risen from the dead, save us who sing to you. Alleluia. O Christ our God, and by death have trampled death, being one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit, save us. Come, let us sing joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim God our Savior. O Son of God, risen from the dead, save us who sing to you. Alleluia. Risen from the dead, save us who sing to you. Alleluia. The stone was sealed by the Jews. Soldiers guarded your most pure body, but you, Savior, arose on the third day, granting life to the world. Therefore, the heavenly powers acclaimed you, O giver of life. Glory to your resurrection, O Christ. Glory to your kingdom. Glory to your salvation, you alone love us all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen. As God, you arose in glory from the grave, and raise the world with you. Human nature praises you as God, and death has vanished. Adam sings in exaltation, O Lord. Eve freed from bondage, Christ joyfully. O Christ, it is you who give resurrection to all.
For you are holy, our God, we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen. Holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Let us be attentive, peace be to all, wisdom be attentive.
May your mercy, O Lord, be upon us. May your mercy be upon us, who have placed our hope in you. Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous ones. Praise from the upright is fitting. May your mercy, O Lord, be upon us. May your mercy be upon us, who have placed our hope in you.
Wisdom.
A reading from the second epistle of St. Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians. Brethren, let me say this much. He who sows sparingly will reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will reap bountifully. Everyone must give according to what he has inwardly decided, not sadly, not grudgingly, for God loves a cheerful giver. God can multiply his favors among you, so that you may always have enough of everything, and even a surplus for good works, and it is risen. He scattered abroad and gave to the poor. His justice endures forever. He who supplies seed for the sower and bread for the eater will provide in abundance. He will multiply the seed you sow and increase your generous yield. In every way, your liberty is enriched. Through us, it results in thanks offered to God.
Peace be to you, wisdom be attentive.
Amen. God, grant me vindication and subdue people under me. Alleluia. 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 He has given great victories to his king, and has shown love for David, his anointed, and his descendants forever. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Peter out fishing. It happened after Jesus had Simon Peter. Go out into the deep of the earth. In the world you will find people. Catch them. Get them. Bring them in. Bring the people to me. When Jesus left the carpenter shop, he began complaining. He said, you know, the time is coming. The kingdom of God is near. So you should repent and start believing in the gospel. Jesus at once called people to follow him. He didn't say, well, why don't you think it over? If you want to come to me, you can do it maybe tomorrow, next week, or whatever. He said, come now. Now is the time. And so something about Jesus' unique personality compelled them to follow him. What if they have not followed? What if nobody followed? You and I would not be here today in this beautiful church, this place of worship. Certainly we would not be gathered in Jesus' name. We would not call Jesus our Lord. We would not call him our blessed Savior. Somebody had to follow him. Follow his message to have survived and to have called us. Think of the world without Christmas, without Easter, without Pentecost, without any hope of salvation or forgiveness or the assurance of God's love and his presence in our daily lives. Jesus calls and asks and needs fishers of people. Consider the hopelessness that would assault us and overwhelm us. If standing by the grave with any of your loved ones or friends, and you had absolutely no real hope of ever being reunited with them. Believing our Lord knew precisely what he was doing when he chose to travel. He knew what he was doing when his resurrected body appeared to them and taught them. And when he said to one and all, go now, make disciples of every nation. We understand that though the words were given to Jesus' first followers, they were also meant for you and I. We are connected to them. Because of them, we are Christians. Yes. When Jesus told his first followers that they were to be go fish for new followers, it is a given that followers in every age have a commission. We have Jesus' mandate to go fishing for new followers. Yes, each one of us has a great responsibility. I love it so much, and I remember when our Metropolitan William was our bishop. He loved to tell people when he visited churches, I want you to do something for me. I want you to go out and bring in one single solitary person to join his church. If each of you attracted one single solitary person, you can imagine how we would fill up these pews. We love to say that to people. So we brought out the theme and teaching of our blessed Savior Jesus. To be fishers of new followers. We have the challenge in whatever way we should, using whatever talents you have, whatever resources you have. Jesus asks you to go fishing with him and for him. But we will consider it and search for how Jesus wants us to use this for his sake. You're going to discover the wonderful reality, also the blessings of it. On Judgment Day, perhaps, when we're all standing in line to be judged, you may look around and see people you know very well. You walk up to the judge, Jesus. They may say to you, be kind and merciful to this person.
He was a fisher for us. This is a wonderful blessing of going out to be a fisherman for people. We should realize that there are people all about us. It could be a neighbor across the street who's lonely or forgotten. We are the people who we work, wherever we recreate. They just really need the good news of the gospel of Jesus. They need to know that Jesus loves them and accepts them and is looking for them to travel with them through life and into eternity. Indeed, they may be some of us worshiping here today as well. The gospel story is actually asking each of us, are we witnessing Jesus living in us? Jesus told us to do this. He said, now go fishing and see what happens. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us all say with our whole soul, with our whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Serve in our spirit in this holy church.
Spirit.
offering it your own of your own, always and everywhere.
We praise you, we bless you, we thank you, O Lord, and we pray to you, pray to you. Blessed Immaculate and the Mother of our God, more honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare more glorious than the seraphim, who a virgin gave birth to God the Word. You truly the Theotokos we magnify.
Spirit of your holy churches in peace, safety, honor, and glory.
that you are truly Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Accept me today as a partaker of your mystical supper, O Son of God, for I will not reveal your mysteries to your enemies, nor will I give you a kiss as did Judas, but like the thief I profess you. Remember me, O Lord, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Master, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Holy One, when you come in your kingdom. May the partaking of your holy mysteries, O Lord, be not for my judgment or condemnation, but for the healing of soul and body. O Lord, I also believe and profess that this which I am about to receive is truly your most precious body and your life-giving blood, which I pray make me worthy to receive for the remission of all my sins and for life everlasting. Amen. O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. O God, cleanse me of my sins and have mercy on me. O Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned without number.
Approach me, dear God, and in faith.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord is God and has revealed himself to us. I shall take the chalice, the chalice of salvation, and call upon the name of the Lord, and call upon the name of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give me your body, O Christ. Savior and sovereign, O guest divine. Come and rest in my soul. Christ, living God, now and forever. Salvation's cup I receive, filled with your body and purest blood. Lord, my poor cry now perceive, that I may share your life divine. Lord, my poor cry now perceive, that I may share your life divine. So great is God in power and glory. No mortal tongue can ever proclaim. So great his throne and power sublime. Bless us, we pray, for you are our soul treasure. O Lord, our God, to you we give glory. Bless us, we of your holy, divine, immortal, pure and life-creating mysteries. Keep us in your holiness so that all the day long we may live according to your truth. Blessed be the name of the Lord, now and forever, now and forever, now and forever.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and loving kindness, always now and ever and forever.
Amen. to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Give the blessing. His grace.